ArcGIS Pro now includes a tool to help you model how water moves and accumulates in a scene. Let's introduce you to flood simulation. For this example, I'm going to focus on a major rainfall event around Nose Hill Park north of Calgary. From the analysis ribbon, let's click on the simulation button and choose rainfall. Next, I'll need to define the area of interest. So I'll click on the map to pinpoint the center. I can then interactively define the area's radius, or I can type the letter R and type in the radius to be 1,000 meters wide. I can use the toolbar below to refine the area, but I'm cool with my 2x2 kilometer square block, so I'll create the simulation area as shown by this orange boundary. Now it's time to create the simulation scenario, and admittedly, I'm going to do something a little crazy. From the simulation ribbon, I'm going to set the rainfall rate to 100 millimeters in 1 hour, a very extreme number. Of course, you should try to create a more realistic scenario. In the configuration panel, you can establish settings such as variable rainfall rates, starting water levels, and infiltration rates. Also, you can change the simulation symbology to show either water depth or flow rate. It also includes a number of predefined color schemes. But for now, I'll keep it simple and just hit run to start the simulation and see what happens. For time's sake, let's speed up the simulation, showing the 1 hour of rainfall in just a few seconds. Notice how the rainfall flows and accumulates, especially in the residential neighborhood below. After 1 hour of heavy rainfall, here's a look at the end of the simulation. The picture looks bleak, but you can always rerun the simulation with some mitigation features to protect the houses. I can insert channels, water sources, and barriers to see what impact they would have. So for this scenario, I'll clear the simulation and add a 2x2 meter barrier along the main road. Then I'll run the simulation again to see the new results. Here's the end of the simulation with the barrier. We can compare the results with the simulation without the barrier to see the differences. You can click on the location to open the pop-up window and quickly see the water depth, speed, flow rate, and direction. Or for deeper analysis, click the Analysis Results button to open the Export Simulation tool. This will create TIFF images at given time slices of the water for the area of interest. You can then use these images in Spatial Analyst for further analysis. The Flood Simulation tool, new to ArcGIS Pro 3.3, allows you to model and visualize water flow. Give it a shot.